Today I am Nikant Pal, working in DP Sundwani Lambachowan as MSTGT. In my today's video, I'll explain
the chapter 9, Relief from Footprint Without Feet, written by K.A. Abbas. Vijay Ahmed Abbas.
He was an Indian film director, novelist and story writer.
In this story, we'll come to know about a girl named Holi.
So this is a story of a girl named Sulekha. And people used to call her Holi because she was a simpleton girl. Simpleton means a person, a foolish person who can be tricked easily by others. So when she was 10 months, she fell off from her bed. And due to that, her brain got injured. And at the age of 5, when she started speaking, she started stammering. So whenever she started speaking, the other children used to make fun of her due to this stammering habit. And she always feel ashamed of her. Her father name was Ramlal. Although the Ramlal was a labrador, he was a rich farmer. He had 7 children and 3 sons. He had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters. And Holi was the youngest of them. Her all adult sisters, they were married and they were beautiful and healthy. But Holi was not intelligent nor beautiful. That's why Ramlal always concerned about her for her marriage. So one day what happened, when she was 7 years old, in her village a school was open for girls. So the district collector advised her father, Holi's father Ramla, to send her daughters to school. But her wife said they couldn't send the daughters to school. Then they decided they would send Holi to school. When Holi reached to school, she was surprised in school because she was first time to reach in school and she was shocked. Because everybody used to make fun of her. When she met her teacher was a kind woman and she always encouraged her, and due to this she started speaking properly. Her stammering habit had gone. When she became young, her father decided to get her married. So on the day of her marriage, she took a bold step. Let's read the chapter and we find out what happened on the day of her marriage.
About the author, Khwaja Ahmed Abbas, also known as K.A. Abbas, was an Indian film director, screenwriter, novelist and a journalist in the Urdu, Hindi and English languages. So students, now I'll explain the entire story line by line. So this is a story of a girl named Sulekha. Her name was Sulekha, but since her childhood, everyone had been calling her Holi. So the name of the girl was Sulekha, but since childhood, everybody used to call her Holi, the simpleton. Simpleton means the person who is not normal like other people, and she was not intelligent and not normal like other children. She was a slow learner and everybody could easily fool her, and this was the reason everybody used to call her simpleton. She was the fourth daughter of Nambardar Ramlal. What do you mean by Nambardar? Nambardar means village head. So she was the fourth daughter of Ramlal. When she was 10 months old, she had fallen off the cot on her head and perhaps it had damaged some part of her brain. When she was 10 months old, then what happened? She had fallen off from the cot, and due to this her head got injured, and perhaps that was the reason of that she had damaged some part of her brain. That was why she remained a backward child and came to be known as Holi. And that injury in brain was the reason of her. She always remained a backward child. And everybody called her as Holi, the simpleton. At birth, the child was very fair and pretty. But at the birth, she was very pretty. She was very beautiful. But when she was 2 years old, she had an attack of smallpox. So by birth she was very fair and pretty or beautiful, we can say. But when she was 2 years old, then what happened? She has an attack of smallpox. You know, smallpox is a kind of skin disease. Only the eyes were saved, but the entire body was permanently disfigured by deep black pockmarks. Her entire body was permanently disfigured. There was a black spots of smallpox. Only her eyes were saved. Little Sulekha could not speak till she was 5. And when at last she learned to speak, she stammered. Usually what happened, the children, they start speaking at the age of 2 or 3. But this girl, Sulekha, when she start learn to speak, she stammered. Stammered means she fumbled with the words, repeating many times the same word. The other children often made fun of her and mimicked her. And when she used to talk to others, and when she used to talk to with other children or play with other children, they often made fun of her. And mimic means they imitated her or they copied her, because they were making fun of her. As a result, she talked very little. And due to this, she always felt ashamed and talked very little. Ramlal had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters, and the youngest of them was Bhuli. Now, Ramlal had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters, and the Bhuli was the youngest of them. It was a prosperous farmer's household, and there was plenty to eat and drink. All the children except Bhuli were healthy and strong. So, the Ramlal was a very rich farmer because he was village head, and there was plenty of food for children. All the children except Bhuli were healthy and strong. Except Bhuli, all other children of Ramlal, they were very healthy and strong. The sons had been sent to the city to study in schools and later in colleges. You know, in earlier time what happened, there was more importance to given to sons. So the sons of Ramlal, they had been sent to school for study and later in colleges. During those time, there is not the girls, they get married in early childhood, but the boys, they used to go to schools and colleges, and the girls, they had to sit at home and do the household work. Of the daughters, Radha, the eldest, had already been married. The eldest daughter of Ramlal, that is Radha, she had been already married. The second daughter, Mangala, marriage had also been settled. And the second daughter's Mangala, her marriage was also settled. And when that was done, Ramlal would think of the third Champa. And when the Mangala's marriage was done, settled, then he thought about the next one, that is Champa, the third one. They were good-looking, healthy girls, and it was not difficult to find bridegrooms for them. And all the girls were good-looking and healthy and beautiful. And for them, it was not difficult for Ramlal to search or to find bridegroom for them. But Ramlal was worried about Bhuli. She had neither good looks or nor intelligent. But the main concern of Ramlal was Bhuli, because he was worried about her, because she was neither beautiful nor intelligent, because he always thought that who would get married to Bhuli. Bhuli was 7 years old when Mangala was married. The same year, a primary school for girls was opened in this village. So Bhuli was 7 years old when her elder sister Mangala was married. At the same year, what happened in school, in village, a primary school was opened for girls. The Tehsildar Sahib came to perform its opening ceremony, and Tehsildar Sahib means the district collector. He came to village for the opening ceremony. He said to Ramlal, as a revenue official, you are the representative of the government in the school, And so you must set an example to the villager. So he advised Ram Lal, as he was a revenue official and he was the representative of the government in the village. So he must be the role model for the other villagers. So he must set an example to the other villagers. You must send your daughters to school. And he also advised that he must send his daughter to school. Because in those days, what happened, it was custom that the only boys, they have to go to school. If Ram Lal would send his daughters to school, then what happened? So that the other people would inspire and they would also send their daughters to school. That night, when Ram Lal consulted his wife, she cried, "Are you crazy? If girls go to school, who will marry them?" So after getting the advice from Tehsildar, he went to his wife. At night, he consulted his wife about sending his daughters to school. Then his wife became angry and he said, "Are you mad? What would happen if the girl would go to school? Then who would get married with them?" But Ram Lal had not courage to disobey the Tehsildar. But on the another side, Ram Lal had not that much courage that he could disobey the Tehsildar. And according to him, his wife was also right. At last, his wife said, "I will tell you what to do." At last, his wife gave him a suggestion that send Bholi to school. Then what she gave the suggestion, she said, "We should send to Bholi. As it is, there is a little chance of getting married. Because why were they ready to send the daughter Bholi to school? Because as I told you, in those days, it was the custom this girl has to stay at home. And if the girl is educated, nobody would ready to marry the educated girl. So they were ready to send to Bholi because she was not intelligent and she was not beautiful with her ugly face and lack of sense. And on they also said because she was ugly face and lack of sense, so there was very less chances, little chances of getting her married. Let the teachers at the school worry about her. The next day, Ram Lal caught Bholi by the hand and said, "Come with me." So her wife said, "Let the teachers took some pain and worry about her." The next day, what happened? Ram Lal caught Bholi, pulled her hand and said, "Come with him. I will take you to school," and said to her that he would take to her to school. Bholi was frightened. And Bholi became frightened because she never heard the name of going to school because her only brothers were allowed to go to school. She did not know what the school was like because she was not knowing what was the school like and what was the school actually. She remembered how a few days ago their old cow Lakshmi had been turned out of the house and sold. She remembered that a few days before, their old cow named Lakshmi had been turned out of the house and sold it somewhere. "No, no, no," she shouted in terror. And she thought maybe her father was also taking her somewhere to sold out. She shouted in terror. She became frightened and shouted. She started screaming and pulled her hand away from her father's grip. And she pulled her hand away from her father's grip. Bholi wanted to run away from her father's hand. She wanted to escape from her father's grip. Grip means her father had hold her hand tightly. "What's the matter with you, you fool?" As she was a simpleton girl, her father also addressed her, "Fool, what happened to you? What happened to her?" shouted Ram Lal, and he screamed loudly, "I'm only taking you to school." Then he said in angrily that he was taking her to school. Then he told his wife, "Let her wear some decent clothes today." Actually, what happened, she was not good looking and she was not intelligent and she was not being cared properly at home. So that day, Ramlal said to his wife to give some decent clothes to her on that day. Or else what will the teachers and the other school think of us when they see her? Because that day she was going to school, if she would have gone to school in such a dirty and untidy clothes, and what the other people would think about them. New clothes had never been made for Bholi, and she was not good looking and pretty, and the parents also treated her very badly, and they never gave her new clothes. The old dresses of her sisters were passed on her, and she always used to wear the old clothes of her sister. No one cared to mend or wash her clothes. In home, nobody was cared about to repair her clothes and wash her clothes. But today she was lucky to receive a clean dress which had shrunk after many washing and no longer fitted champa. But today it was the first time she was getting a new dress to wear, and that of her elder sister Champa, and after a long wash that dress was shrunk. Shrunk means reduced in size, and it was not fitted for Champa. She was even bathed, and oil was rubbed into her hair and matted hair. She was being given bathed, and oil was properly rubbed into her hair and matted hair. Matted hair means untidy hair, because her hair was dry and untidy. Only then did she begin to believe that she was being taken to a place better than her home. So after that, getting new dress and her hair was properly combed, then she has been taken to some good place. She was not being dragged like the old cow. Then she realized. When they reached the school, the children were already there in classroom, and when they both, the Ramlal and Bholi, when they reached to school in the classroom, the students were already there in the class. Ramlal handed over his daughter to the headmistress, left alone. When they reached the school, Ramlal handed his daughter to the headmistress and he went to his home. The poor girl looked about her with fair leaden eyes, because the girl had gone out of her home for the first time, and she was very frightened, and she looked at the headmistress with full of fair leaden eyes means full of fear. There were several rooms, and in each room girls like her squatted on mats. Squatted means to sit with one's knees bent. So there were several rooms, and each room the girls like her, they were sitting on the mats, reading from books and writing on the slates. And those time, you know, the student, they used to write not in the notebooks, they were used to write on the slates. So the girls, those who were sitting on the mats, they were reading and writing on slates. The headmistress asked Bholi to sit down in a corner in one of the classroom, and then headmistress said to Bholi that she had to sit in somewhere in the classroom in the corner. Bholi did not know what exactly a school was like and what happened there. Actually, the first time Bholi went outside from her home, and she was not aware about what its school actually was and what happened there. But she was glad to find so many girls almost of her own age. But on the other side, she was very happy because she had seen many girls of about her age. They were present there. She hoped that one of these girls might become her friend, and she was thinking that might be one of among of these girls one could be her friend. The lady teacher who was in the class was saying something to the girls, but Bholi couldn't understand nothing. And in the classroom, the lady teacher, she was telling something to the girls, but the Bholi, as she was not intelligent or not normal, so she was not able to understand anything what the teacher was telling them. She looked at the picture on the wall. The colors fascinated her. The horse was brown, just like the horse on which the tehsildar had come to visit their village. When she was in the class, she looked at the picture which was hanging on the classroom wall. And she was fascinated towards those colors. The house was brown, just like the house on which the tehsildar had come to visit their village. She recognized the horse because it was of brown color, and she compared that horse with the horse that tehsildar had to visit to their village. The goat was black, like the goat of their neighbor. Then she looked at another picture that was of goat, and she compared the goat she had seen her nearby neighbor's place. The parrot was green, like the parrot she had seen in the mango tree. And then she saw another picture that was of parrot, and she compared that parrot with the parrot she had seen in the mango orchard. And the cow was just like the Lakshmi. Then see another picture, she compared that picture with her cow. It was just like the Lakshmi. As she was admiring the beautiful picture was hang on the wall, on the same side, she was not able to understand what the teacher was telling to the girls. And suddenly Bhuri noticed that the teacher was standing by her side. And suddenly the teacher had come towards her from the back side. Smiling at her, "What's your name, little one?" And the teacher gave her a smile and asked her about name. "What's her name?" Bho. She could stammer no further than that. As we know, she couldn't speak properly. She stammered. Then she tell her name, Bho. Then afterwards she stopped. Then she began to cry, and tears flowed from her eyes in helpless flood. Then she started crying because she became frightened and started crying, and tears flowed from her eyes just like a. She continuously started crying. She kept her head down as she sat in her corner. And as she was sitting in the corner, and she kept her down, not daring to look up at the girls who she knew were still laughing at her. Because when she used to play with children nearby her home, they always made fun of her just because of her stammered. Then again she was thinking here, she didn't dare to look at up to those girls because she was thinking that those girls were making fun of her. They were still laughing at her. When the school bell rang, all the girls scurried out of the classroom, but Bhuri dared not to leave her corner. When the bell rang, all the girls of the classroom, they hurriedly come out from the classroom. But Bhuri dared not to leave her corner, because she was very frightened. Her head is still lowered, and still she kept her head lowered. She kept on sobbing. Sobbing means crying noisily. And she kept on sobbing. Bhuri, the teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. Then teacher said Bhuri, the teacher's voice was very soft and soothing. In all her life, she had never been called like that. And this was the first time that somebody had treated her very softly, and somebody took her name very nicely and smoothly. It touched her heart. "Get up," said the teacher, and the bully was very happy because somebody had treated her very nicely, and her teacher told her to get up. But just a friendly suggestion. When Bhuri heard her teacher's voice, and she didn't feel it was a command, and she thought it's just a friendly way she had asked. Bhuri got up. She got up. "Now tell me your name." Sweat broke out over her whole body, and the girl was feeling very frightened, and due to this, her entire body was covered with sweat. Would her stammering tongue again disgrace her? Then she was thinking herself that again she became stammered, and for that again she had to be embraced. For that sake of this kind woman, however, she decided to make an effort. Although she was in dilemma whether she could speak properly this time or again she would stammer, but The teacher asked her very politely and in a soothing way, and the bully thought for the first time somebody had treated her very nicely. For the sake of that teacher, she decided to make an effort. She decided to speak one more time. She had such a soothing voice, she would not laugh at her. And she was thinking that the teacher had a soothing voice and her teacher would not laugh at her. Bho, she began to stammer. Then she started to speaking again. She began to stammer. She said, bho. Well done, then her teacher admired her, appreciated her. Well done, the teacher encouraged her, and the teacher encouraged her. Come on now, the full name. Then her teacher encouraged her and said her, now full name, tell the full name. Bho, Bholi. Then at last she said her name was Bholi. At last she was able to say that it and felt relieved as if it was a great achievement. At last when she spoke her name, Bholi, she felt very relieved, and it was a great achievement for her because she was always stammer and nobody had encouraged her to speak nicely. Well done, the teacher patted her affectionately and said, put the fear out of your heart and you will be able to speak like everyone else. Then her teacher patted her affectionately with love, patted her with love and said, keep your fear out from your heart and one day you will be able to speak like other children.